time to prepare for the transition. But unfortunately, this bill will only confuse customers by changing the date, cost more money, and hurt public safety. It will not give a single television viewer off the coupon waiting list. It will jeopardize the spectrum that police and firefighters say they need. Since 9/11, we've been hearing this, and as our good friend from Virginia, Mr. Boucher, has already stated. And I don't know under what circumstances the national police chiefs and fire chiefs have written, but my local people are saying exactly the opposite. And also, this will jeopardize the spectrum that the original DTV legislation clears for advanced wireless services, perhaps our nation's quickest and most realistic way to improve broadband deployment, stimulate the economy, and create jobs. Now, if we're going to move this date to tornado season in Nebraska, let me use this Nebraska analogy about waiting so that we're at 100% of people already hooked up, which seems to be our new standard here. Let me give the story about Tom Osborne, three-time national championship coach of the Huskers. When he decided to run for Congress after being coach for, I think, almost 30 years in three national championships, he pulled and found out that he had name ID in Nebraska of 95%, meaning 5% of the Nebraskans had never heard of Tom Osborne. Yet we're holding up this legislation here today because 5% of our nation, although they may have the coupons in hand, have not hooked up yet. If we're going to wait till 100%, we're going to come back and delay this again.